line out there again. Datsyuk in on goal. Scores! Pavel Datsyuk, his first National Hockey League goal, and they don't come any prettier.
I think Pavel's the most exciting one-on-one player in the world.
I like to call him Houdini because he's almost invisible.
He brings you out of your chair every time he touches the puck. You want him anyway, so he comes to you.
Here's a lead feed. Datsyuk in on goal.
Situation, power play, penalty killing, even strength. He's that dangerous at any moment and very deceptively quick.
Here's a break take by Datsyuk.
I really think that Pavel and Henrik Zetterberg are two players that we're going to build around up front. You know, they're really going to be the face of the franchise, and it was important to lock up Pavel on training.
Pavel Datsyuk.
Born in 1978 in Severodvinsk in the former Soviet Union, now Ekaterinburg, Russia, Pavel Datsyuk knew little of the NHL, but what he did know made a big impression.
I know a lot about NHL. When I see a couple games, it's my dream. I want to be there. I want to try. It's my goal to go through, and I'm there.
How hard was it for you to come to the United States with basically no knowledge of English?
Yeah, it's... For me, it's hard. I learned a little bit French in my school, and it's not help. I don't know French now. And now I feel it a little bit more comfortable myself. It's well, I speak English, understand. I can explain what I want. Not everything, but better.
One hockey person who had seen you play as a kid, small kid, said, what he does with his hands, not normal. When did you know that your hands, your stick work, was special?
Every player have huge sight. Mine maybe is a good part. I have good handle and somebody. Brett have good shot. And you need to use it. I try to use it. My huge.
Your upside. Were you always that good, though? Were you always able to stick handle around other players when you were a kid?
Maybe because I'm not strong, it's a puck too heavy, I try to moving this way.
But you weren't big. Yeah. At some point, you sort of grew into your body a little bit. You're still not a big man, but you sort of sprouted a little bit, right?
When I come first time in training camp, he say, we like you, but you need more physical. And when I come back to, I'm use it 2 years to my physical shape.
To the wings, veteran Brett Hull was crucial in helping him develop an NHL style. Hull, Datsyuk, and Boy Devereaux would form the infamous two kids and an old goat line in the 01-02 Cup season.
You know, Brett Hull was so important for us because he could score goals. You know, they all brought different dimensions. Boy Devereaux brought incredible speed and did a lot of the work back checking. Pavel was the playmaker. You know, Boyd was a lot of the legs, Pavel was the brains, and Brett was the finisher.
It was almost like a match made in heaven, a guy who could really handle the puck and really take the defenders' concentration away and make them focus on him. And I do what I did best and get open. And he was not only a great stick handler, but he could really see the ice and pass the puck wonderfully.
Here came Luke Datsyuk, what a move! Datsyuk in on goal!
I want to ask you about Brett Hull. How much did he impact your career? Because he loved you. I mean, he was your biggest fan in trying to get your name out to other people around the world of hockey.
I learned from him a lot. He chef unbelievable to play. He just find a spot where easy to pass him. And he every time he opened and I find a good spot for shoot. And he helped me in locker room. He just told me, no, don't worry, everything's fine. We score, don't worry.
Datsyuk into the zone, waits, delays, nice move, but with another nice move. Datsyuk across, what a play, they score! Datsyuk for Johan Franzen. A Datsyuki and Deke found Franzen's side of the goal, and the Red Wings have the first lead of the game.
Dave Hakstol, the head coach of the University of North Dakota, came to the game and sat in my box. the game we played, the Anaheim Mighty Ducks. When the game was over, Dave and I walked down to the locker room, and Dave, first thing that Dave told me was, it was his first chance to see the Detroit Red Wings live, and he said, Pavel Datsyuk is worth the price of admission all by himself.
Franzen back into Datsyuk. What a turnaround, his culture. It's not a nice way to celebrate a birthday.
Look at this, and the crowd recognized what happened,
oh, sure.
And we're going, oh my God, what did we just see? We're going to see this and still get amazed. Watch Logan Couture right here. He's a forward. Oh my, oh my.
Back for Datsyuk. Look at that. Play around like one. Datsyuk. Finds it. Licky. Scores! Oh, was that magic?
He is now playing the way I expected he could for the last couple of years. He's put it all together. He's a lot stronger than he was a few years ago. Stronger on his skates. He can take some checks and not be knocked down and not getting up. He's right back into the play. He brings you out of your chair every time potentially he touches the puck. You have a highlight reel play or a goal.
I think Pavel's the most exciting one-on-one player in the world.
Maybe the best player in the league, lots of tricky stuff. When you were growing up in Russia, were you always a guy that liked to hang onto the puck and do tricky little things with it?
I like to do, but some in the period where I've been a youngster and some with my teammates, he always yell at me and say, give me a puck, something, and I try to be not too much dangle. Some period, yeah, I like to handle puck and dangle, but sometimes it's hard, some big defenseman to hit you hard, and you... Next time you're thinking more like before.
The Frank J. Selke Trophy goes to Pavel Datsyuk.
I will not speak longer, but my English short. Thank you.
And the winner of the Lady Bing Award this year is Pavel Datsyuk.
Hello again. But I come to first time, I have this, I forget because I'm nervous. First time now and I have nothing. I just I want to say thank you very much, and my rank is short now.
If you were to have one word of advice or a couple of words for young hockey players out there, what would they be?
Never give up. It's, I know sometimes you want to, like, someday I'm try to, like, shut down a little bit, but... I'm happy I'm not shut down and I'll be there, and someday you'll be there and I'll be enjoy to Red Wings or another team. It's every 20,000 people watching you and share it to you.
Pavel, thanks for this. Good to see you back in the lineup Thursday night.
Oh, thank you very much.
Pavel Datsyuk.
Trev takes on. We've got Pavel Datsyuk. He and I are going to play a little bit of keep away. I don't have much of a chance, but it will be fun. But before we get to that, a couple of questions for you, Pav, and the stick handling game. Obviously, one of the more gifted stick handlers in the league.
Comes Datsyuk up there with Eisenman. Datsyuk in on goal! Scores!
What's your secret?
I think it's not too much secret. I mean, it's... you need to keep it puck away from defenseman, and it doesn't matter how you do it. And not make it too much risk where you play.
Somebody told me, and I don't know if it's true or not, confirm this, that when you were younger, you used to stick handle with a barbell and a weight on the end like this to work on your wrist. Is that true?
It's not special. We do every,
every guy on the team, we have similar drill kind of, we use it to, what do you say, barbell?
Yeah,
it's for more, a little bit more stronger.
Can you show me anything?
I don't have nothing.
Okay, well, let's play some keep away. I'll see what you've got.
Rafalski to Filppula. Lundqvist is there. Datsyuk stole it from him. Scores!
This guy leads the NHL in takeaway, so I get the puck first, so at least I get to touch it. Deal?
Like many great players, Datsyuk is almost obsessive about his stick. Teammates say they can't believe how heavy his are, and he's got more stored in the team's stick room than any other player.
Pavel, I heard that you keep a lot of sticks. How many do you got here?
Thanks for Ibak, he sent it to me a lot. I can try it every time different, and I use it, try find it my best one, and so far it's working for me.
I've heard that you're very particular about them.
Yeah, I think it's a different way. You can say you're really picky. Yeah, I'm really picky with stick, and maybe I'm learned from Brett Hull too. He just too much checking, looking, same maybe me.
What do you look for? What do you like in a stick?
Lots of things. It's so you can explain it. You need to feel it sometimes. It's like, yeah.
Can you grab one and hold it and show us what you look for?
Sure. Yeah. Yeah.
That's the other thing about Datsyuk. As current and former teammates say, he's got a wicked sense of humor once he gets comfortable with you. For example, listen to him describe his part on the 2002 Stanley Cup championship team.
What do you think of when you see that picture?
This good memory, good to be Rocky. Mm-hmm. And then you sit on the bench and win cup. It's so fun.
You did a lot more than sit on the bench that year.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, I just give it to water for people too.
He knows everything. Very smart. He knows everything. Sometimes he'll play it off, you know, language barrier, but he knows.
It's not only what Datsyuk does on the ice that sets him apart. On a team full of workout fanatics, he is probably the ringleader. As a matter of fact, there have been times where Mike Babcock has asked him to tone it down.
Well, I still have to. I mean, I remember a few years back, we were getting ready to play St. Louis, and him and Zetterberg were in there doing hurdles. And I'm saying, what are we doing? We need to win against St. Louis. And they said, we need to get ready for the playoffs. You know, that's why he is special, is because he's so determined.
Your teammates say, and the fans of the Red Wings say, that you should get more attention for how good you are.
I wish not, because it's a take my time. Lots of interview, needed thinking too much. Now I'm just work, done, do my
Everybody,
stuff.
It's going to be fantastic.
Why don't
take
we
it away,
Heels.
Datsyuk.
Yeah. Okay. Go ahead, Heels.
Okay. This all world tonight, did absolutely everything. But, you know, even little things like face-off, 63% on the draws, 100% against LaPierre. Didn't stand a chance of winning any of them. 63% against Henrik. So when you start with the puck, 63% of the time, this guy is magic. And, you know, I'll give Babcock credit. He takes stats on how these center icemen do during the game. It's the backup goalie. There is the monster. Little piece of paper. He hands it to the coach. The coach knows, okay, LaPierre's on the ice. I'm going to put my star out there, Datsyuk, because he's going to win me the draw.
Yeah, smart coaching right there.
Not only does he win it,
he wins it to himself, which is, it's just
focus, strength.
Yeah, it's so much fun to watch. And he has like a canoe for a blade.
Like Yannick Perot used to have a stick like that, right? Yeah. And he was another guy who was well known for
great face-off man, Yannick Perot.
His hockey IQ, too, is off the charts. And there was one back check where he shows you exactly what he's thinking as he's going back for the puck. He knows that this player, the right-hand shot, has to bring the puck to that side. So instead of going to his left side, he goes to the right side, and there it is, off the stick. He also knows there's a trailer coming. Higgins is coming in the play. Take away that passing lane. And when the puck then gets turned over, he doesn't even look. He knows it's Higgins. He knows which way he shoots. He's a left-hand shot, and he breaks up the play. Tonight, and I know he struggled at times for the year, that is a player. I hope he, with this lockout, hasn't pushed this guy to go back.
That's the big question.
One of the greats in the league. One of the greats in the league. But a few other Canucks, though.
He's got, Datsyuk's got, I just want to follow up on what Glenn said. He's got one more year left in his contract. He's going to be 35 this summer. And the talk is that he enjoyed playing in Russia so much that he will go back after next year. And just as a North American hockey fan, you hope we get to see more years of him.
Definitely hope that we get to see more of him.
I don't think it's been him that's been struggling. I think it's the, I mean, you've taken Lidstrom off that team on the back end. Do you think he ever had to wait for a pass ever? It was all, he just put his head down and boom, it was always on the tape. They just don't have the back end in Detroit to support the offense that they have. And they're missing some guys on their power play as well. So it's a big different team, and he's still so much fun to watch. So even when you showed when he doesn't have the puck, I think he's so much fun to watch how smart he is when he doesn't have the puck.
So I coached against him when I was in Anaheim, and I just thought he had the puck on a string. I never knew he was going to be as good a two-way player as he is.
Carries on, drops back to Stahl, in for step. Good back check by Datsyuk. Dave jammed it along, Patrick Kane. Second thought about
just a small
all of that.
Town,
meanwhile, Stahlberg stripped of the puck by Pavel Datsyuk.
She took the midnight train going anywhere. Just a city boy, born and raised in South Detroit. He took the midnight train going anywhere.
Here in Washington, as we are now at the halfway mark, stolen it all alone. That's it. Let's go.
Where's the jockstrap? Oh my gosh, wait to see the replay of this. Oh, it was jockstrap. Oh my goodness, what an awful play to make. Last guy back in an unbelievable deke by Pavel Datsyuk, and he stuffs it home and you're ever.
All right, this is the Pavel Datsyuk tribute in our NHLPA Hockey Night in Canada poll. Datsyuk wins 6 categories. Smartest player over Sidney Crosby. And I'm sure Crosby being out has a lot to do with his low total there. Datsyuk wins who's the cleanest player in the NHL. Marty St. Louis, a Lady Bing regular, and Nick Lidstrom. Which player is the toughest to take the puck away from? Pavel Datsyuk over Malkin and Crosby. Yager, of course, when he sticks his butt out, he's always a great in that category. Pavel Datsyuk wins the toughest forward to play against, and that's a whole different kettle of fish versus Milan Lucic in at number 2. The player that's the most difficult to stop, Datsyuk defeats Steven Stamkos in that one, and the most difficult player to play against, Pavel Datsyuk beats Zdeno Chara, and everybody hates to play against Chara if you're a forward. All defensemen would be terrified of Datsyuk.
Well, let's take a look at his handiwork because we're always in awe every time we watch him play. And as you said, Ron, most difficult to take the puck away from. But also, I think what's so difficult about playing against him is if he loses a puck, that's where he does best. He wants it back better than anybody else. And he's so good at protecting the puck. He competes against guys bigger than him and more willing to try creative things like that move right there. You
this
know,
is nasty right here. Watch it? This one right here. Whoops.
You know, it's almost as though the guys are so afraid of him, they give him too much respect. And that's why he's more than willing to try these things. And that goal is just crazy.
Well, because they don't want to be on our highlight reel just like that. And I'm going to show you something from a few years ago. It was 2004, and it was a penalty shot. And I was with the Philadelphia Phantoms at this time. And watch this move here.
We tried that for an hour and a half in practice. We moved the net up because we were falling. Watch the other players. Watch the bench. I look, the trainers are high-fiving. Did you just see that? Look at this. Goes to the one leg, pulls it in. It's just, and he's just so calm and cool about it. And it was, that is just sums up him. And he's just, after just smiles and continues as if it's nothing. And we were twisted ankles. We were falling into the boards and just great to watch. Great to watch.
And smartest player is where you place the puck, not just offensively, but defensively. And discipline is a huge part of that particular category. Back over to the Chevrolet Eye Desk, Elliot.
Like Adele at the Grammys is Pavel Datsyuk. He cleans up. It's his night. Story about him at the All-Star game.
Well, at the All-Star game, Zdeno Chara went up to Tim Thomas and said, if I get first pick, do you mind if I take Pavel Datsyuk? I always wanted to play with him. I'll take you in the next round. And, of course, that's what happened.
All right, good choice. And they wanted Ron to make sure Chara did to make sure that he got the respect of being the first player in that draft.
Now, we'll continue with the move.
I love watching Sid, and probably Datsyuk would be the two that I'd say I watch the most.
Probably just the guy I like to watch most is Datsyuk.
I got two, Claude Giroux and Pavel Datsyuk.
Probably Datsyuk. He's got the best hands I've ever seen.
I gotta say Pavel Datsyuk. Everybody, eh?
I try to don't watch hockey, I don't know why. We have too many meetings, it's enough.
One back in there.
favor with Datsyuk making great moves. Oh. Scores! Oh. Oh, what a dangle of a snipe!
Thank you. Thursday with 113 feet. Another from the scores! Pavel Datsyuk's done it again!
Second effort, dropped it on now. Motoring in is Datsyuk. Datsyuk, the backhander, he scores! My goodness!
The Datsyuk, the host up. Datsyuk goes, there it is! Scores! What a mega beauty!
To make here.
In front of the goal, Datsyuk scores! Back into Datsyuk again, great chance, scores! Didn't get it earlier, he got it!
A minute to go in period two, good play at the line, Datsyuk holding in, right in, shoot, scores! Pavel Datsyuk with a roof shot, what a beauty!
Moves behind the Holmstrom and running, couldn't pull the trigger, back to Lindstrom again, turns it back over to Datsyuk, Datsyuk with a shot, he scores!
The stick of the Oilers. Datsyuk, plays, shoots, scores!
Now here's Datsyuk. Here's Datsyuk shoots and scores. Left to high.